these are just another couple of pieces I did a week or so ago. Just to show the technique really and how it all comes out.
And these you posted on your page in Facebook, if I remember right, didn't you? Yes, you did, yeah. Yeah, they're very, very nice. This one here, I like in particular. Yeah, just 1 minute. So, collaboration, the action of working with someone to produce something. He wrote a book in collaboration with his son. Okay. Detail. Military collaboration. See France. Okay. Oh, here we go. Woodturning. Collaboration with woodturning. Inviting a better turner to work on a project with you with the aim of looking better than you really are. Okay. Hello, William here again. And welcome to this week's project video. This week, I'm doing a collaborative project with... hang on. Hang on. Hi, Alan. It's William. How are you? I'm good. Thank you. Busy this evening. Fancy coming down for a beer? Okay. Yeah, see you in about 10 minutes then. Okay. So this week's project video is going to be a collaboration project with Alan Maggs. Okay, for those of you who do not know Alan, Alan has a Facebook page branching out. I'm very fortunate that he lives a short distance from me in Yeovil in Somerset. Alan is particularly noted for very fine and interesting detail using acrylic paints on things such as bowls, platters and tea lights. Okay, so before he gets here, I'm going to rough turn a wide-rimmed bowl from this piece of elm and a couple of tea lights from a piece of sycamore and, I think, maple. Now, I turned two tea lights, although I'm only going to show one on screen. These are a bit of an odd shape, but I wanted a wide rim on there because this project is basically about decorating with acrylic paints. Now, I'm using ebonizing lacquer on all three pieces as a foundation base for the colouring.
Now, I can imagine some comments regarding the bowl about why I'm using a nice piece of elm for this project. In fact, this piece of wood was rescued from a firewood pile and exhibit lots of cracks because basically the pith goes right through the centre. Okay, while I'm waiting for Mr. Maggs, a couple of shout-outs. Firstly, to a gentleman who contacted me on my YouTube channel seeking some advice for his fledgling YouTube channel. So it's hi to a Courtland Hacker across there in Superior, which is near Denver in Colorado, if I remember correctly. Now, I've put a link to Courtland's YouTube channel in the text and up here. Courtland claims he's only been turning for a couple of years, but looking at the quality of his work, I'm suspicious that it could be much longer. Anyway, he's obviously got a penchant for turning burrs, or burls as you call them across there in the US, and he's produced some outstanding work. So please go and check out Courtland's YouTube channel and subscribe and help him develop his skill that he's already showed a lot of talent in. Now, the second shout out is to a young lady called Suzy, who has a YouTube channel called Suzy Dragontail Turnings. Now, Suzy came and introduced herself to me and to many other turners who were demonstrating at Yandal's seeking advice. She's recently become very interested in wood turning and also has a fledgling YouTube channel. Now, Suzy has obviously got a great deal of support from her parents, who have bought her all of her birthday and Christmas presents up until next Christmas and beyond. So again, I'll put a link up here to Suzy's channel and in the text. Please go along, have a look, and encourage this young lady into this wonderful world we have of turning.
I assume then if the effect doesn't come out with these paints so well,
we can
scrub it and then...
Yes, just do it again. Yes. Yeah. So what are we going to do? Use these three Pivo colours, which is, what colour is that? Violet. This one's violet. It's good there. Violet.
Orange.
Blue.
Orange.
Blue-green. So we've got orange, blue-green and violet. It's definitely recording this time.
Twist if you want.
So you're twisting it.
Twisting slightly.
gives a kind of this cold effect almost. This was always filled in, you can leave the bits of black.
There
you have it.
I think that looks good.
Just take this off. So this one I'll try a bit of
Joe Son, yes.
Some iridescent. Strangely enough, all the colours, as you call them, come out white.
Yeah, that's a bit odd, isn't it? It's a bit like my blue resin cast and it came out yellow. Yeah, it may be the viscosity of the Joe Sonia paint is better for this.
Well, that's another fresh blue on this one.
It's not inflated enough. I think the Joe Sonia paint is better. Don't you?
It seems to bring out a better.
Yes.
What's your effect?
I'm sorry to say, I can see it's ripping off the. Yes, it's a better. I think the viscosity of the Joe Sonia paint is much better. Don't you?
Yeah.
It's leaving the ridges. And we've tried chestnut, way too runny.
Yep.
The chestnut paint's way too runny.
It seems to bring out the better effect.
It does, yeah.
And when that dries out, these ridges will just be highlighted.
Yeah, but I wonder why they stay white.
This I don't know.
Well, no, it just does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Again, there's a nice...
You've got, are those just the colours you got? Well, we should try some different colours.
We have got other colours here.
All right, let's take that one off then. Hang on. Yeah, I rough turn these. They do look a bit rough, don't they?
They are a bit rough. I don't know what you're turning with them. A spoon?
Yeah, but it was a sharp spoon.
Right, so let's try this one for a bit more.
Actually, when you need to chop... When you need to quickly produce three items, it's amazing how quick you can do it, isn't it?
Yeah, it's amazing what
you can
do with a spoon.
That bowl was a bit of elm, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah, but it was a bit of firewood elm. It was full of splits and cracks. But, obviously, I had to hide them for the top, but the bottom of it came up okay. So I'll probably finish it.
It was rapidly turning into a polygon. Okay. And then just a half inflated blue.
So what was the colours we had there?
That was
red?
Yeah. Bit of gold and blue, I think. And this one we can.
Yeah, it's much better.
Just leave a bit of black shine through.
Yeah.
So we can go obviously right the way over, but
yeah, don't have to.
Sometimes it pays us to.
No, I think that's good as it is.
Leave a bit of the undercoat if you like.
Yeah. I think that's good as it is.
That's a good effect.
Yeah.
There we go.
Right, so we need to mount this back on the lathe and just turn that centre out. Let's see how true that is running. Ooh. I think we can do better than that, don't you? Stop there for very long, in fact, at all, am I? Not sure how secure that is. Tell you what, I always... Have you ever jabbed your elbow in the tailstock in the spot?
Once or twice.
I don't bloody leave it there anymore. Yeah, it just needs tidying up a bit, I think, you know. Have a first outing with my Simon Hope super scraper.
Yeah,
that is a super scraper, isn't it? But I'm going to have to steel myself to use it the right way up, because intuitively to me it should be that way up. Still got a couple of ridges in there, but it's all right. We're good?
That's a beast, isn't it?
You just got to keep it flat, that's all.
This way up, yeah?
Yep, that way up.
That's a good finish.
It's a good finish. I'd sand that now with, what, 240? It does, yes. Just give that a couple of seconds to dry. We'll de-nibble that. And again, I've gone over to the
Yorkshire grit.
Hey, do you put it on with a towel? I put it on with my fingers.
Oh, do you? I've got a towel, you see it.
So, yeah, it's just a couple of layers of... See how good my taping is. You see all the cracks are in here. That's why I decided to use it for this.
You could put what's over the top of this as well, I guess, couldn't you?
Yes, yeah. Ah. Yeah, let's put another coat of fiberglass on the back. Then we'll claim victory. Thank you.
Looks very nice. Nothing wrong with that at all, is there? Yeah, I use frog tape quite a bit. It is low tack and it's much easier to deal with than normal masking tape. It's just twice as expensive.
There we go. So that's the base.
Yeah, that's okay. That's okay, isn't it?
Right, just remains then to remove this. Okay, there is nothing wrong with that at all. I'm impressed both with this technique for using Joe Sonia paints and also with Simon Hope's scraper.
Yeah, that was very good. That
yeah, good. Well, I do like this collaborating.
Yes, yeah, so I'm sure you do, because you didn't do a huge amount yourself, but...
Oh, well, that's why I like that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that, and it's time we went and had a thirsty ferret.
Good idea. Let's go.
That's good.
Good idea.